Welcome, dear students, in the second lecture of Chapter 5, Linear Equations in Two Variable, Standard 9, Mathematics, Part 1. Children, let us recall what we have studied in previous module. We have studied about linear equations in two variables. An equation of the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where a, b, c are real numbers such that a is not equal to 0, b is not equal to 0, is called a general form of linear equation in two variables x and y. If and only if a and b both are not 0 at the same time. Every linear equation in two unknowns has an unlimited number of solutions. Then we have studied simultaneous equations. Two or more different linear equations having unique set of solutions are called simultaneous equations. Method of solving simultaneous equations. There are mainly two algebraic methods of solving simultaneous equations. First, method of elimination by equating coefficients. And second, method of elimination by substitution. Learning objectives of this module. In this module, we are going to learn applications of simultaneous linear equations. Some of the real-life problems can be expressed in mathematical form by using linear equations in two variables. While dealing with such problems, we must follow the steps given below. First, make assumptions using two variables, say x and y. Second step, from the given information, frame two equations in terms of two variables. And third step, solve the equations. So in this chapter, we are going to apply substitution and elimination method to solve the sums. By plus c is equal to 0. Solution, let the number of 5 rupee notes be x and that of 10 rupee notes be y. The value of x notes of 5 rupee is equal to rupees 5x and the value of y notes of 10 rupee is equal to rupees 10y. The total amount of these notes is given to be rupees 350. From the first condition given in the question, we get 5x plus 10y is equal to 350. Dividing both the sides of this equation by 5, we get x plus 2y is equal to 70. Number the equation as 1. From the second condition, we get x is equal to 2y minus 10. By rearranging the equation, we will get x minus 2y is equal to 10. Number the equation as 2. Now, look at the coefficient of variable y. They are opposites. Therefore, we can add equation 1 and 2. By adding equation, plus 2y and minus 2y get cancelled and we get 2x is equal to 60. Therefore, x is equal to 60 upon 2. So, the value of x is equal to 30. Substituting x is equal to 30 in equation 2, here you can substitute in any of the equation. We get 30 minus 2y is equal to minus 10. Therefore, minus 2y is equal to minus 10 minus 30. Which is equals to minus 2y is equal to minus 40. Now, cancelling minus sign on both the sides, we will get y is equal to 40 by 2, which is equals to y is equal to 20. Answer, there are 30 notes of 5 rupee each and 20 notes of 10 rupee each, as x is the number of 5 rupee notes and y is the notes of 10 rupees. Second question, the denominator of a fraction is 1 more than the twice its numerator. If 1 is added to the numerator and denominator respectively, the ratio of numerator to the denominator is 1 is to 2. Find the fraction. Let us see the solution in the next slide. Solution. Let the numerator of the fraction be x and denominator be y. Then the required fraction is x upon y. Twice the numerator is equal to 2x. From the first condition, y is equal to 2x plus 1. By rearranging the equation, we get 2x minus y is equal to minus 1. Number the equation as 1. Now, 1 is added to the numerator and the denominator. Thus, the new numerator is x plus 1 and the new denominator is y plus 1. According to the second condition given in the question, we get x plus 1 divided by y plus 1 is equal to 1 by 2. By cross multiplying, we get 2 into x plus 1 is equal to 1 into y plus 1. Therefore, 2x plus 2 is equal to y plus 1. So we get 2x minus y is equal to 1 minus 2. Therefore, 2x minus y is equal to minus 1. Number the equation as 2. You can observe now equation 1 and 2. These both equations are same. There can be infinite values that will satisfy the given conditions. By substituting x is equal to 1, we get y is equal to 3. Similarly, if you substitute x is equal to 2, we will get y is equal to 5, and so on. Therefore, the required fractions or the fractions which we will get are 1 by 3, 2 by 5, 3 by 7, 4 by 9, and so on. Question number 3. The sum of ages of Priyanka and Deepika is 34 years. Priyanka is elder to Deepika by 6 years. Then find their today's ages. Solution. Let the ages of Priyanka and Deepika be x years and y years. From the first condition, x plus y is equal to 34. Here, the sum of ages of Priyanka and Deepika has given 34 years. So, we have written x plus y is equal to 34. Number the equation as 1. From the second condition, Priyanka is elder to Deepika by 6 years. Therefore, x is equal to y plus 6. By rearranging the equation, we get x minus y is equal to 6. Number the equation as 2. Now, you can observe the variable y which have coefficient opposites. Therefore, adding equation 1 and 2, plus y minus y get cancelled. We get 2x is equal to 40. Therefore, x is equal to 40 by 2, which is equal to 20. So here we got the age of Priyanka is 20 years. Now, substituting x is equal to 20 in equation 1, we get 20 plus y is equal to 34. Therefore, y is equal to 34 minus 20, which is equal to 14. Therefore, age of Deepika is 14 years. Answer: Priyanka's age is 20 years and Deepika's age is 14 years respectively. Question number 4. The total number of lions and peacocks in a zoo is 50. The total number of their legs is 140. Find the number of lions and peacocks in the zoo. Solution: let there be x lions and y peacocks in the zoo. From the first condition given in the question, x plus y is equal to 50. The total number of lions and peacocks in zoo is 50. Number the equation as 1. A lion has 4 legs. Total number of legs of lions is 4x. A peacock has 2 legs. Therefore, number of legs of peacocks is equal to 2y. From the second condition given in the question, we get 4x plus y is equal to 140. Dividing throughout the equation by 2, we get 2x plus y is equal to 70. Number the equation as 2. Subtracting equation 1 from 2, we get 2x plus y is equal to 70 minus x plus y is equal to 50. Plus y and minus y get cancelled and we will get x is equal to 20. Substituting x is equal to 20 in equation 1, we get 20 plus y is equal to 50. Therefore, y is equal to 50 minus 20, that is 30. Answer: there are 20 lions and 30 peacocks in the zoo. Question number 5. Sanjay has monthly fixed salary. There is an yearly increment of a fixed amount in the salary. After 4 years, his monthly salary was rupees 4,500 and 10 years his monthly salary became rupees 5,400. Find his original salary and yearly increment. Solution: let the fixed monthly salary of Sanjay be rupees X and the yearly increment be rupees Y. Then in 4 years his salary was X plus 4Y is equal to 4,500. Number the equation as 1. And in 10 years it was X plus 10Y is equal to 5,400. Number the equation as 2. Subtracting equation 1 from 2, we get here plus x and minus x get cancelled and we get 6y is equal to 900. Therefore, y is equal to 900 upon 6, which is equal to 150. Substituting y is equal to 150 in equation 1, we get x plus 4 into 150 is equal to 4,500. Therefore, x plus 600 is equal to 4,500. Now, take this 600 on another side. We get x is equal to 4,500 minus 600, which is equal to 3,900. So here we got x is equal to 3,900. Answer: Sanjay's original salary is rupees 3,900 and yearly increment is rupees 150. Question number 6. The price of 3 chairs and 2 tables is rupees 4,500 and the price of 5 chairs and 3 tables is rupees 7,000. Then Find the price of two chairs and two tables. Solution: let the price of chair be rupees X and that of table be rupees Y. From the first condition, we get 3x plus 2y is equal to 4,500. You can see here in the question, the price of 3 chair and 2 table is rupees 4,500. From this, we got first condition. From the second condition, we get 5x plus 3y is equal to 7,000. Number the equation as 2. Multiplying the equation 1 by 3 and equation 2 by 2. We get 9x plus 6y is equal to 13,500. Number the equation as 3. Multiplying equation 2 by 2, we get 10x plus 6y is equal to 14,000. Number the equation as 4. Now, subtracting equation 3 from 4, we get x is equal to 500. Here, plus 6y and minus 6y get cancelled. Therefore, x is equal to 500. Here, we have to find the price of 2 chairs. Therefore, 2x is equal to 2 into 500, which is equal to 1000. Number the equation as 5. Substituting x is equal to 500 in equation 1, we get 3 into 500 plus 2y is equal to 4500. Simplifying it, we get 1500 plus 2y is equal to 4500. Therefore, 2y is equal to 4500 minus 1500. Therefore, 2y is equal to 3000. Number the equation as 6. Now, we have to find the price of 2 chairs and 2 tables together, which is equal to rupees 1000 plus 3000. That is equal to rupees 4000. From equation 5 and 6. Answer: the price of 2 chairs and 2 tables is rupees 4000. Question number 7. The sum of digits in 2 digits number is 9. The number obtained by interchanging the digits exceeds the original number by 27. Find the 2 digit number. Solution: let the digit at the tens place be X and that at the units place be Y. Then X plus Y is equal to 9. You can see here in the question, the sum of digits of 2 digit number is 9. So, our number in tens place is X and units place is Y. So, X plus Y is equal to 9. Number the equation as 1. The value of the digit X at tens place is 10X and the value of the digit Y at units place is Y. Children, you have learned place values of the number in lower classes. Therefore, original number is 10x plus y. From the given condition, 10y plus x is equal to 10x plus y plus 27. You can see here, the number obtained by interchanging the digits. So, our original number is 10x plus y. When we interchange it, we will get 10y plus x. It exceeds the original number by 27. Our original number is 10x plus y. Therefore, we get here 10y plus x is equal to 10x plus y plus 27. Exceeds means increases. Therefore, by simplifying it, 10y plus x minus 10x minus y is equal to 27. we get 9y minus 9x is equal to 27. Dividing both the sides by 9, we get y minus x is equal to 27. Number the equation as 2. Now we can observe the equation 1 and 2. By adding equation 1 and 2, we get 2y is equal to 12. Here plus x and minus x get cancelled. Therefore, y is equal to 6. Substituting y is equal to 6 in equation 1, we get x plus 6 is equal to 9. Therefore, x is equal to 9 minus 6, that is equal to 3. Now we got value of y and x. Therefore, the original number is 10x plus y. Substitute the value of x and y here, we will get 10 into 3 plus 6, which is equal to 30 plus 6, that is 36. Answer, the original two digit number is 36. Question number 8. In triangle ABC, the measures of angle A is equal to the sum of the measures of angle B and C. Also, the ratio of measures of angle B and C is 4:5. Then, find the measures of angles of the triangle. Solution: let the measure of angle B be x degree and angle C be y degree. From the first condition given in the question, angle A is equal to angle B plus angle C, which is equal to x plus y. According to the given second condition given in the question, x upon y is equal to 4:5, that is 4/5. Therefore, 5x is equal to 4y. By rearranging the equation, we get 5x minus 4y is equal to 0. Number the equation as 1. The sum of the measures of the angle of a triangle is 180 degrees. By using this angle sum property of a triangle, we can write angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degrees. Children, you can observe the figure on the screen. Angle B is x degree, angle A is x plus y degree, and angle C is y degree. Substituting all these value here, we get 2x plus 2y is equal to 180 degrees. Dividing throughout equation by 2, we get x plus y is equal to 90 degrees. Number the equation as 2. Multiplying equation 2 by 4, we get 4x plus 4y is equal to 360 degrees. Number the equation as 3. Adding equations 1 and 3, we get 9x is equal to 360 here. Plus 4y and minus 4y get cancelled. Therefore, x is equal to 40. Substituting x is equal to 40 in equation 2, we get 40 plus y is equal to 90. Therefore, y is equal to 90 minus 40, which is equal to 50. Here, angle A is equal to x plus y. Therefore, by substituting the value, angle A is equal to 40 plus 50, which is equal to 90 degrees. Answer, angle A is equal to 90 degrees, angle B is equal to 40, and angle C is equal to 50 degrees. Question number 9. Divide a rope of length of 560 cm into two parts such that twice the length of the smaller part is equal to the 1/3 of the longer part. Then find the length of the larger part. Solution: Let the length of the smaller part of rope be x centimeter and larger part be y centimeter. From the first condition we get x plus y is equal to 560. Number the equation as 1. Twice the length of the smaller part is equal to 2x centimeter. 1/3 length of the larger part is equal to y by 3 centimeter. From the second condition we get 2x is equal to y by 3. Here by multiplying 3 on both the sides we will get 6x is equal to y, or simply if this 3 from the denominator will take on another side, it will multiply to the 2 and we will get 6x is equal to y. Rearranging the equation we get 6x minus y is equal to 0. Number the equation as 2. Observe the coefficient of variable y, they are opposite, so we can add the equation 1 and 2. By adding equation 1 and 2 we get x is equal to 80. Here plus y and minus y get cancelled. Substituting x is equal to 80 in equation 1, we get 80 plus y is equal to 560. Therefore y is equal to 560 minus 80, which is equal to 480. Answer: the length of the larger part of the rope is 480 centimeter. Question number 10. In a competitive examination, there were 60 questions. The correct answers would carry 2 marks and for incorrect answer, 1 mark would be deducted. Yashwant had attempted all the questions and he got total 90 marks. Then, how many answers did he get wrong? Solution: suppose Yashwant got x correct answers and y wrong answers. From the first condition, x plus y is equal to 60. Number the equation as 1. For x correct answers, he got 2 into x, that is 2x marks. For y wrong answers, y into minus 1, which is equal to minus y. Therefore, y marks are deducted. So he got 2x minus y marks. From the second condition, 2x minus y is equal to 90. Number the equation as 2. The first equation is x plus y is equal to 60. Rearranging the equation in the form of x, we will get x is equal to 60 minus y. Substituting x is equal to 60 minus y in equation 2. 2 into 60 minus y is equal to 90. Simplifying it, we will get 120 minus 2y minus y is equal to 90, which is equal to 120 minus 90 is equal to 3y. Therefore, 3y is equal to 30. Y is equal to 30 by 3, which is equal to 10. Answer: Yashwant got 10 wrong answers. So children, you have to practice all the sums properly in your notebook. We will meet again. Till then, take care of yourself. Thank you.